So for those of you that I didn't get a chance to meet yesterday, I'm Andre Gorovinovich. I'm in product planning for Genesis here in the U.S. I'm going to walk you guys through a little bit more about the product of the Genesis G70 itself. So Luke talked to you guys about the dynamic refined design of the car. I'm going to cover the performance aspects of the attributes of the car, some of the class-leading safety features that we have, and a lot of the technology that we have in the G70. So starting a little bit more about the exterior and the interior of the car. So the G70 has a very long hood, like Luke said, very short front overhangs, giving it a really dynamic side profile. It's actually lower and wider than most of the competitors in this segment. It also has a longer wheelbase than many of the competitors in the same segment. And to go along with the sleek exterior design of the car, which you see obviously above the surface of the car, below there's a lot of work that was obviously done to keep the underneath and some of the other elements of the car also very sleek as well. So it features a complete end-to-end under body cover, active air flaps in the front grille, as well as air curtain that kind of help deflect some of the air and kind of clean up some of the turbulence around the front wheel. Other elements too, like brake cooling ducts obviously come underneath to kind of help keep, especially the Brembo cars, keep those brakes nice and cool so you can stay out on the more negative driving elements a lot longer. The G70 has, there's three different wheels that we're going to offer here in our market. So the standard wheel is an 18-inch wheel. It has a semi-gloss metallic finish with MX M4 all-season tires. The two 19-inch wheels have summer tires, and they're both the Michelin Pilot Sport 4 tires. I'll talk a little bit later about a special edition that we have that kind of takes that up to another level a little bit. Both 19, so some of the more, I guess, design-focused, elegance-focused, and luxury-focused packages, the 19 is a 10-spoke machine finish wheel. The Sport package has its own unique wheel, so that's the 5-spoke wheel. So you see some of the cars out there have this really nice dark spotter finish 5-spoke wheel. So the Sport package that I just talked about, so there's a lot of other design elements to the package itself. So, you know, like I mentioned, the wheel is unique to that package. As is, you know, most of the chrome in the car has a really nice dark chrome finish. Everything from like the BLO trim around the windows to the front grille, even you know door handles and some of the metal trim pieces around the outside rear mirrors. The headlamps have a unique copper and black bezel, so the majority of the internals of the headlamp are black, and there's copper details around the main projector. Tail lamp covers have a dark tint to them, so it kind of gives the Sport package car a little bit more of a dynamic look to it. The interior also, you know, a lot of this car's focus on you know delivering some exciting driving feel and driving performance. So the interior has a lot of the elements that kind of help bring the driver closer to the driving experience. So the seat is very low, it's actually the lowest we've had in any of our products, low to the ground, so you know bringing you closer to the center of gravity of the car, getting you to feel a little bit more engaged with the driving experience itself. It's got a very really slim A-pillar. And also the outside rear mirrors are set kind of low, so you'll see that on the track. You get some really good visibility, especially in the corners where the body's kind of rotate the other way, looking for the next apex. You still get some really good visibility. But that doesn't mean you know the interior is tight by any means. You know it has more front leg room, shoulder room than all the competitors in the segment. It has the most more interior volume than many of the cars in the segment. So it gives you know some good space for not just the driver, for everybody else that's going along for the ride with you. Talk a little bit about performance. So you know, before we build any vehicle, you know, you have to start off with a really strong, really rigid, and very lightweight platform. So the platform in this car, brand new platform, what we call the C2 platform, has a lot of really you know material strength materials where necessary. We feature a lot of aluminum where you know we felt was you know it was good to kind of help bring some of the weight down on the car itself. So things like the hood and the front strut bars are made out of aluminum. The platform, you know, being very rigid, allows us to obviously fine-tune some of the other components of the car. So if you start with a great baseline, you know, you can fine-tune the suspension to, you know, kind of achieve that optimal balance of ride and comfort. So I think we've achieved a really good kind of a car that's great fun, you know, on the twisty roads, but obviously doesn't in any way compromise ride comfort. And obviously, you know, some of the key targets of the platform is to achieve, you know, good, obviously, occupant safety. We're hoping to achieve it's a 5-star rating, TSP Safety Plus. So hopefully, you know that's the goal, along with delivering good driving performance as well. And to go along with that great platform that we have, G70 will have. We're going to have two powertrains here in the U.S. The four-cylinder turbo is up 252 horsepower, 268 pound-feet of torque, and it's available really at the very low end of the torque curve, so you see some of the numbers up here on the screen. That torque is available all the way to 1400 RPM, the full amount of torque. The 3.3 turbo, 365 horsepower, 376 pound-feet of torque, so again, the torque is available very early on. It's a pretty exciting motor to drive. And to kind of help you drive that engine and roll the gears, I guess, in a way, the 8-speed automatic transmission is standard on both models. Features paddle shifters, rev matching, with ESC disabled, gear holding during cornering. So it's a pretty engaging transmission to drive. The shift speeds as you move from comfort mode to sport mode actually shifts a little bit quicker, so it's a pretty fun transmission to drive. For a lot of you guys here in the room, this is probably the most exciting part of the car, which a manual transmission is available. Our 2-liter turbo does have a manual transmission option. Doesn't mean by any means it's a base model in any way. It's actually a really well-equipped car. It has things like limited slip differential, Brembo brakes, and a few other things that kind of make it a very driver-focused package. Related to what I was just mentioning, so along with the powertrain, so there's quite a lot of technology that kind of helps deliver a more engaging, more exciting driving experience. So the front suspension, the standard suspension on the, many of the packages and builds are is a McPherson strut in the front, multi-link in the rear. We have adaptive suspension on the 3.3-liter sport package and one other package that I'm going to mention a little bit later. So that's available as well. And dynamic torque vectoring control that not only looks at applying a little bit of braking in the inner rear wheels to kind of help you to kind of steer around the corners a little bit better, but also looks at things like ESC and engine power and how to kind of in all-wheel drive, so the all-wheel drive cars, to try to figure out how to best deliver power and how to best position the car to lead you to kind of go around the corner the best way possible and actually get you some good corner exit speeds to come out of the corner. And also to help support that, limited slip differential is actually standard on all 3.3-liter models and available on the 2-liter manual transmission that I mentioned as well. Same with Brembo brakes. So all 3.3-liter models, Brembo brakes. Manual transmission also will have the Brembos. Like I mentioned before, driving modes. So obviously many cars in the market have this, but we have 5 different driving modes. You can change things, how your steering feels, your suspension's damping characteristics if you have the adaptive suspension. Even the all-wheel drive system, you can, depending on the mode that you're in, will actually change the characteristics of how much power is being delivered to the front wheels versus pushing a good amount of power to the rear wheels, giving you a more dynamic driving feel. And one thing that's exciting about this car is, yes, you can fully 100% disable ESC. So you might want to try that maybe on the autocross karting track that we have set up today for you guys to drive. So it's kind of fun to let the back end of the car come around a little bit in a safe way. And along with that, so with that ESC off, there's also the availability of launch control. So when you have the ESC fully disabled, depress both pedals fully, and you'll see a graphic come up on the, I see some of you taking photos. There's a card in the car, by the way, that has instructions. So we made it easy for you guys to try that out. It kind of has actually literally these steps in there. Let the revs fully build. You'll see a graphic on the cluster saying launch control ready, I believe is what it says. And then as long as you release brakes within 4 seconds, you'll get that launch. Otherwise, it will actually disable and go back to normal braking. All-wheel drive, I mentioned a little bit earlier. So our all-wheel drive system is available on both powertrains, so both the 2-liter and the 3.3. And like I mentioned, it's a pretty dynamic system. It's obviously it's more than just for those that live in areas with inclement weather. Depending on what drive mode you're in, you're shifting power all the way from 0% on the front wheels and 100 on the rears, all the way to 50-50, equal distribution depending on the characteristics. In the eco mode, if you're on the freeway and you're cruising for a good amount of time, no wheel slip is detected, they will shift most of the power to the rear to actually help you save a little bit of fuel. So it's quite a lot going on in that system. Like I mentioned, the dynamic torque vector control also available with the all-wheel drive, and as well as the limited slip differential. So all that together, it's quite an engaging car to drive. It's actually a pretty fun car to drive. The ultimate expression that. Oops, sorry, make sure I'm on the right slide. Sorry about that. There is actually a drift mode in the all-wheel drive car. So basically, the idea behind this is that you can, with the ESC code disabled, you can send the majority of the power to the rear wheels and take that car around the course as if you're driving a rear-wheel drive car and kind of maintain. And there's even some characteristics that can kind of help sense the slip angle of that the car is doing and kind of the amount of steering input you're giving and help you actually stay on that drift even a little bit longer without fully, you know, fully spinning out. So it's a pretty fun feature of the car. So the car, obviously under the you know, our head of development, Mr. Albert Bierman, is developed all over the world. He spent quite a lot of time in places like Death Valley and Sweden, some of the F1 tracks in Korea. I believe even Buttonville here in the U.S. A lot of you guys might have experience in that local track in California. And of course, the Nürburgring, quite a lot of time spent in the ring to make sure that this car had some good handling characteristics. I'm going to talk to you guys now a little bit about the technology in the car. Safety at Genesis, what we like to say is safety is definitely not an option. So all the features you see up on the screen, including our front collision avoidance assist, blind spot monitors, all those features that are on the screen now are actually 100% standard on every G70. It's something that we've done with both G80 and G90. You know, the suite of safety features is quite comprehensive, and it's 100% standard. Every model. On the multimedia side, the standard screen is an 8-inch touchscreen. The screen itself has what we call technology called installed touch technology. So basically, the touch sensors are on the same plane as the LCD itself. So basically, it allows the screen to be extremely thin, and also allows it to even touch control the commands of the car with gloves on. So it's kind of depending on the weather, you know, if you're in Michigan or somewhere cold weather, you can actually control most of the features in the car with gloves on still, which is kind of nice. And that standard head unit is actually pretty well capable, right? So it's got Android Auto CarPlay, XM, and HD radio. So that's all standard on every G70. The navigation system, again, you know, talking about HD radio, has traffic data piped via the HD radio service. And it's subscription free, so for the 100% of the time of the ownership, there's no need to have a separate subscription for tracking. It also features cloud-based voice recognition, so for a lot of the commands like searching POIs or address entry and things like that, the command will actually be sent to the cloud and back to the car. What that allows us to do is different accents and different ways of speaking things, and you can save the address 100% the full one shot of the way, and then we'll come back to the car and give you the right POI back into the car itself. It also allows even though we have annual map updates that I mentioned here on the slide as well, it allows that data to be even fresher because you're going off board from the car. So if a new local restaurant pops up, you can still find it. On the sound side, Lexicon, as we feature also as well, G80G90. But on this car, it sounds incredibly amazing. 15 speakers, including two subwoofers underneath the two front seats. Especially when you're driving, make sure you guys listen to it. I believe there's USBs in the car with some sample music for you guys to try. And it definitely sounds really good. Those two subwoofers underneath the seat give it a nice full sound to the car. It features a couple other technologies that also in our other vehicles. So Clarify music restoration and quantum logic surround. Clarify is really exciting for those of us that bring outside music into the car. It's not just amplifying the track, it's actually remastering the track itself, kind of separating that voice elements and the instrumental elements, and kind of actually fine-tuning how that should be reprojected out to the car. So it does a really good job of kind of bringing out the sound if you have low quality audio in the car. And I believe it actually even does that with the XM as well. So even the XM, some of the XM channels coming into the car, it kind of brings out some of the best elements of the sound coming back in. As Urban mentioned, connectivity on this car is a big piece. It's 3 years subscription. It's included with the G70 for the Genesis Connected Services. The focus of these technologies is on safety, car care, remote. So it allows you, the remote portion of it is to me pretty exciting side of things, right? So it allows you to control many of the features in the car. And it allows you to do that in a variety of ways, everything from the app on your phone to Apple smartwatch, or also the Android smartwatches as well. And even like Urban mentioned earlier, picks up more Google devices from your house. So you can, as you're getting coffee ready in the morning, kind of get the car cooled or heated before you get out there to drive. And there's quite a lot of other technology in the car. I don't obviously don't have a chance to cover everything here, but there's a lot of technology in the car focused on convenience, on just making the car comfortable and good to drive and useful every day. So things like smart trunk are standard on the car. So basically, as long as your key fob's in your pocket and you approach the rear of the car, you'll start hearing a sequence of three beeps, and on the third, the trunk will pop open for you. So if you're carrying a lot of things in your hands, it's pretty convenient. Other things, you know, like one of my favorites, the passenger walk-in device. It may not seem like such a big deal, but it's kind of a nice, kind of convenient feature. You know, you have the ability to control that passenger seat from the driver's side. So if you just went out to lunch with a bunch of coworkers and they move the seats all over the place and you don't like that seat being so far forward, you can, you know, bring it back and kind of readjust it and make it easy for you to pay for your driving on the home. And that's also standard on all of these settings. So to kind of summarize a little bit, I talked to you guys about these four main development goals of the car. So the design aspects, the performance characteristics, our class-leading safety, and then some of the technology that's available in the product. But to finish it off, I'm going to walk you guys through a little bit about how we plan to sell the car in the U.S. as far as colors and packages. So as you see out there, there's quite a dynamic range of colors. G70 will have 8 standard colors in the palette. The Majorca blue, the photos in the middle, looks amazing. It looks pretty stunning in photos and driving. Definitely a good-looking car. In the sport, especially in the sport package with the dark wheels, it looks really good. But it's a pretty wide range of colors. I love some of the dynamic edition you guys drive out on the track. Havana red is also pretty stunning to look at. On the inside of the car, two primary colors in 3 different materials. So everything from our synthetic leather all the way to Napa quilted leather, both gray and black. And on the black interior, one of the options, instead of having a full black instrument panel upper portion, there's also a burgundy option, which looks really good in certain lights. You have a burgundy upper IP, and then the upper trims on the upper doors are also burgundy as well. On the sport package, the interior is black, but there's 2 different options of stitching. So you can either get a gray contrast stitching or red contrast stitching. And that stitching carries not only on the seat, but also some of the details on the instrument panel all the way down to the center console. And you'll see it kind of complements the car really well. Kind of get a nice sporting kind of character to the car. I talked a little bit about package strategy. I'm not going to go through all the details here, but if you guys have any specific questions, you can pull off time at the track or at lunch or in between to go through some of the package availability. Our advanced package car, I mentioned before, it's extremely well equipped. The connected services are standard. The display audio with XM and HD radio is standard. Smart trunk. There's quite a lot of the advanced package cars. There's quite a lot of equipment, and then all the way up to the sport package cars. Very dynamic duo. And to kind of celebrate the launch in the U.S., there's two special editions. So the first one, the dynamic edition, there's actually, I believe, a few here on the drive, on the route for you to drive over to the track. And this dynamic edition has a unique exterior color. It's a black forest green. It looks beautiful, and in many lights it looks like a dark gray, but when the sun and the certain lights hit it quite right, the green pops, and to me it's for sure my favorite color of this car. It also has a unique interior. It's a cream leather on the inside. And it has a Genesis crest on the headrest, on the driver front seat headrest. It looked really, really, really nice. So it's a pretty good combination of styling, but also it has a lot of capability, right? Because all 3.3 liters have LSD and Brembo brakes. You see the Brembo brakes in this car are actually super, so they kind of, they don't quite stand out as much as the reds, but then, the idea of this car is to be a little bit more on the elegant design side of things. And then the complete opposite twin of this guy is the dynamic edition. So I mentioned before the Pilot Sport 4s on the 19-inch wheels. This car actually has Pilot 4s, which are a little bit more grippy, a little bit softer tires, so it's actually really great on track. Quite a lot of grip. It has upgraded brake pads, as well as a unique tuning to the dynamic suspension. So you can see a little bit more damping, a little bit more body control than not that the sport one doesn't, but this one kind of brings it up to a little bit more higher level of it. And also some upgraded thermal capabilities of the car, so things like more power to the radiator, actually larger cooling system, or some of the electronics feeding the cooling system. So it kind of gives a lot of capability to the car to actually stay out of in a more performance driving situation even longer. that's basically all I have for you guys, and bring Urban back up here.